Hello and welcome to the episode 79 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we have interviews and prizes, the completion of a song, and a wedding. On the 20th of March 1961, we have a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club for the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums. Then, in the evening, the band paid a visit to the Hambleton Hall for their seventh performance there. Both venues are in Liverpool. More Cavern for the Beatles in 1962. Still featuring Pete Best, the band had an evening engagement at the Cellar in Matthew Street, second in a bill, featuring the Blue Jeans and completed by Ian and the Zodiacs. For the 1963 stop of the Beatles Montez Row package tour at the ABC Cinema in Romford, the main acts were supported by the Viscounts, Debbie Lee, and Tony Marsh and the Terry Young Six. The Beatles still performed their six-song setlist featuring Love Me Do, Misery, A Taste of Honey, Do You Want to Know a Secret, Please Please Me, and I Saw Her Standing There. In 1964, the Beatles were again busy at the Twickenham Film Studios to complete the corridor scenes for A Hard Day's Night. During the day, Ringo Starr was interviewed on the set by Lynn Fairhurst for another snippet of the BBC Radio's Movie Go Round show, aired on the 12th of April between 3 and 4 p.m. In the programme, Ringo's interview would follow the whole band's interview recorded on the previous day. In the late afternoon, the Beatles left Twickenham to reach Studio 9 of Associated Radio Fusion's television house in London for their second live appearance on Ready Steady Go, aired between 6:15 and 7 p.m. Despite the show being live, the Beatles mimed the performance of It Won't Be Long, You Can't Do That, and Can't Buy Me Love, also taking part in some of the comedy skits. In addition, during the show, co-host Keith Fordyce presented them with a prize from US magazine Billboard because of their occupancy of the first three top positions of the US sales chart with three different singles. The band was also interviewed by the other co-host of the show, Katie McGowan. Talking about singles, the 20th of March 1964 also saw the release of the Beatles' sixth single in the UK, Can't Buy Me Love, with You Can't Do That on the B-side. Once again, it's time to remind you to please visit www.simonmas.com/support if you want to prove me how fab you are and be instrumental in helping me out to create even better free content for you to enjoy. You'll find the link in the episode description along with the bibliography of the show, with the usual Amazon affiliate links for your Beatles-related shopping, and another special link, but we'll talk about that in a later section of this episode. On the 20th of March 1965, we have the last day of shooting in Obertauern, Austria, for the Beatles' second feature film, tentatively called Eight Arms to Hold You. The Beatles and their doubles did the usual array of shenanigans on the back of the slopes, and the band recorded bits and bobs to be used in the Ticket to Ride sequence of the film. There was also another scene not included in the final cut of the film, with Ringo and his double in an outdoor restaurant. During the evening, at around 8 p.m. local time, John Lennon and Ringo Starr were interviewed on the phone by Chris Denning for Radio Luxembourg's series The Beatles. 1 year later, in 1966, Paul McCartney and his then-girlfriend Jane Asher returned to England after a holiday in Switzerland. Once in London, Paul moved to his new home at 7 Cavendish Avenue in St. John's Wood, close to the EMI Studios, after the end of the extensive renovation work on the premises. In 1967, during the day, BBC's Brian Matthew managed to convince John Lennon and Paul McCartney to record an interview with him for BBC Radio. It had been quite a task, since the band had decided to keep a low profile during the recordings of Sgt. Pepper's. Starting at Abbey Road from 7 p.m, Matthew chatted with John and Paul, recording an acceptance speech for their three 1966 Igor Novello Awards for Yellow Submarine, the single with most sales in 1966, Michelle, the most performed work of the year, and Yesterday, runner-up for the most performed work of the year. Matthew also recorded a piece for Top of the Pops, in which the two explained the Beatles' change of focus from touring to recording in the studio. The acceptance speeches were broadcast by BBC Radio on the 27th of March between the 2 to 3pm show The Igor Novello Awards for 1966. The rest of the program was recorded live during the ceremony. You'll find a link to it in this episode description. Lennon and McCartney will receive other Novello Awards until the band's breakup in 1970, but they never attended in person and they never recorded special acceptance speeches for their prizes. When Matthew left, John and Paul completed She's Leaving Home with some vocal overdubs, Paul's final version of his vocals, and John's contribution in the chorus, both double-tracked. The song was then mixed into mono, almost one semitone higher than its original pitch. After that, the session was wrapped up. Finally, on the 20th of March 1969, John Lennon and Yoko Ono got married in Gibraltar. It was the happy conclusion of almost a week's worth of attempts after the failure of the couple's plan to get legally united on a ferry and then in Paris. On their arrival, they went directly to the British consulate office, completing the necessary bureaucracy and the ceremony in 10 minutes. In less than an hour, the couple returned to France and to their hotel in Paris. This concludes another episode of What a Fab Day. Tomorrow, we'll have a dangerous drug mistake. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.